Welcome to this training and discover the value you can create with our connectivity management platform powered by Nokia Wing Hub Enterprise Portal.
Internet of Things, IoT, in its simplest form is about connecting a thing to the Internet. Connectivity is the oxygen of IoT and the lifeblood of a successful IoT service. As such, to harness the power of IoT, you must first harness connectivity.
Let's start with the basics before we dive in. IoT connectivity is what connects your subscriptions, your customers over mobile networks. Your supplier provides you with your SIMs, which are uniquely identified in the network by a set of parameters.
Because connectivity isn't something you just turn on at the beginning of your device's lifespan and then turn it off when you're ready to retire that device, you need a connectivity management platform that provides you with ongoing monitoring and management of that connectivity. In addition, working with an operator who is skilled, global and can provide self-service efficiency will also help you keep costs down. At the same time, we manage your resources and the corresponding business processes that an IoT connectivity operator can provide. These include a list of available network services, a PNS, roaming profiles, related prices and other details such as add-ons, and so on, typically specified in the frame agreement you have with your supplier. To effectively commercialize IoT services and to manage millions of IoT devices, you need a solution that has a one-stop shop of unique, fully managed services contracts with committed service-level agreements and services across different markets, a bearer-agnostic IoT platform supporting various technologies, innovative when it comes to SIM management with autonomous provision and disabling of SIMs, and providing a real-time control of devices' infrastructure and services compliant to various regulations in different markets, a secure, multi-country, regulatory-compliant IoT core. Infrastructure to enable global seamless connectivity, a fully managed service for faster time to market based on an innovation partner who can identify and validate new technologies, for example 5G, to come up with new use cases and business models. We know that IoT connectivity is a new paradigm of doing business, because it is the one of business intent driven support operations. Therefore, a connectivity management platform is the business support system of IoT that needs to enable you control your connections, add value to your customers and introduce new connected offerings fast. That is why we are unique in providing a dynamic, in the moment, connectivity management and innovation capabilities based on our connectivity services. So, the result is the one that provides you with intelligent, coherent and interconnected closed loops throughout the business and services layers with a single pane of glass for business design and onboarding, service delivery, business assurance, business intelligence and monetization.
As part of your experience journey, Wing Hub Enterprise Portal provides unique access to related usage and master data, continuous cost optimization, recurrent SIM orders, advanced SIM provisioning capabilities, security and fraud detection. Wing Hub Enterprise friendly feature set is based on real-time online rating and charging, which accurately deals with a dynamic rating for data and SMS, configurable bill frequencies and invoicing. Closed-loop automation and notification framework, which offers a tremendous opportunity of savings through deflection of support calls, avoidance of tier 2 escalations and unnecessary truck roll dispatch while providing the optimal customer experience. Flexible SIM billing status management to effortlessly control your subscription journey, whether to contain connectivity cost, avoid overages, and reduce the overall monthly bill. And Wing Hub provides you with both an automated, configurable and ad hoc SIM billing status management to take control of your SIM assets, device connectivity and billing behavior. Flexible analytics with both out-of-the-box and ad hoc reports to dissect data, including real-time data across a population of SIMs based on a range of filters, in order to instantly understand revenue and usage patterns, identify deviations in usage, determine trends in new subscriptions and their activations, and overall growth of new accounts. Reporting and analytics in Wing Hub provides you with the ability to analyze data usage, costs, performance, provisioning and important usage trends. Overall, it helps you determine if your wireless IoT and machine-to-machine services are working as expected in the field and take timely actions on problems that impact performance and costs. The art of Wing Hub Enterprise Portal is one-stop shop of fully managed services, unique contract with committed SLAs and services across different markets, a single pane of glass with intelligent, coherent and interconnected closed loops from connected devices, bare agnostic network and infrastructure to the business layer of processes, people and peripheral ecosystems. Firstly, we will show how the proper access to their daily business functions on platform can be administered and managed. Secondly, we will visit a connectivity sourcing responsible or someone within finance in their task to optimize connectivity costs. Then, we will look into how we support you to monitor, diagnose, and control subscriptions for quality control, typically a task undertaken by the customer support organization. And finally, how to prevent malicious use, reduce the risk of subscription fraud, or a change of hardware or abnormal behavior. Let's start with how we support you in setting up the users and groups that best match your organizational setup for roles and permissions.
Hi, my name is Austin, and my role is to make sure to ensure the functions of our teams and departments, regional branches, subsidiaries have the proper access to their daily business functions. The connectivity management platform gives me the right tools I need in my role as an account administrator. These include support of hierarchical enterprise organization structures, whether multinational organizations, subsidiaries, business divisions, and/or business line accounting groups, national units, simplified user group access rights, administration of an organization instead of manual individual user accounts, only flexible inheritance of users and access rights always in accordance with the organization's requirements, audit logs of all automated and user-generated actions for the accounts in order to proactively identify non-permitted actions as well as security breaches. The Wing Hub Enterprise Portal allows me to create user groups to simplify the user account administration by assigning access rights to groups rather than individual users. Wing Hub enables me to manage key user group details such as user access rights associated with a specific group, users belonging to a group, effective rights of a group, other objects. For example, the admin user group would have a different set of users and rights in comparison to the help desk user group. Therefore, the proper definition of the user groups will match best our organizational setup for roles and permissions, e.g., grouping users who are dealing with managing SIMs, activating and deactivating them in day-to-day operations, versus a team who is managing the assignment of price plans where commercial aspects apply. Once groups are created to efficiently organize the constituents of an account, such as companies, departments, or teams, I can now start reorganizing SIMs. SIM groups can only be changed for the current account or its direct subgroups. The list of existing SIM cards are listed in a table. I can apply search and filter criteria to narrow the list of SIM cards I need to administer. I can click on one or more SIM cards and the organization icon to assign the SIM cards to a group. The SIM card group window allows me to select a group from the group list to which the previously selected SIMs will be allocated. Wing Hub provides audit logs of all automated and user-generated actions for the accounts in order to proactively identify non-permitted actions as well as security breaches. Examples of actions that are logged in the audit log: user object creation or deletion, automated emails.
Now let us show you how we support you in optimizing connectivity costs.
Hi, my name is Rhonda, and my role is to make sure we get the most value for the money spent on connectivity. My KPIs are in the areas of predictability, keeping the budget under control. The connectivity management platform provides me with a wide range of capabilities that are critical in always keeping the costs predictable and under full control. These capabilities include real-time management of SIM billing status. For example, I can activate/deactivate SIMs when a service is not needed to contain connectivity cost and reduce the overall monthly bill with just a mouse click away. Or I can have peace of mind with proactive actions through the platform's rules in cases when, adjust the state of SIM cards from active to inactive whenever necessary. If data use or SMS frequency from one or more devices goes above a defined threshold, the platform can send a message to right stakeholders in order to ensure the device won't exceed any monthly allotments, which could result in higher costs. If need to temporarily block traffic to and from a device is needed to be blocked, rules can switch the device's SIM to suspend mode. If the SIM-enabled device is lost or needs to be retired after it has reached the end of its life cycle, Rules can switch the SIM to a cancelled state. The platform also provides me with flexible price plan management for manual or automated price plan swaps and the possibility of differentiating rate plan lottery. As part of automated usage monitoring and alignment with optimal rate plans, the dashboard allows me to monitor and analyze critical data for the current billing cycle. I can get quick insights into the total data consumed by our organization for the current billing cycle. The total of assigned subscriptions owned by our organization as on the current date. How many subscriptions owned by an account or group are actually in billing state and thus chargeable as on the current date, and how many SIM rules have been triggered as on the current date. The dashboard can be further customized to include additional important insights such as data usage per country, top data usage by SIM ICC ID for the current billing cycle, organization reports and notes. Batch tasks are a record of objects updated in CSV file import. Account invoice files available for download. Product pools and subscriptions for which account invoice files are available for download. There are other widgets as well, like top spenders for the current billing cycle by group, and the data volume spent. To customize the dashboard view, widgets can easily be maximized or even hidden if not required at all. The platform also provides me with flexible price plan management for manual or automated price plan swaps and the possibility of differentiating rate plan lottery. I can upgrade or downgrade subscriptions to a different plan, add remove subscriptions in order to optimize the monthly usage. I assign price plans to newly added subscriptions or swap from one assigned price plan to another to avoid excess charges. An important aspect in containing connectivity costs and reduce the overall monthly bill is the ability to deactivate subscriptions when a service is not needed until the end of the billing cycle defined by the applied price plan. Changing the billing status of subscriptions allows me to take control of our assets. For example, I can leverage unused resources from expired or terminated subscriptions to be reassigned. I can also meet business needs by activating or getting new subscriptions ready for traffic. Similarly, I can suspend a subscription while not in use so that I can contain costs. Most importantly, the platform's real-time engine ensures that every SIM billing status change is always in alignment with network and inventory status, and this is a compelling feature to cost optimization. I can monitor the actuals of services usage types across a population of subscriptions for informed decisions and forecasts to meet demand proactively. The user query or ad hoc capability allows me to dissect data across a population of subscriptions based on a range of filters in order to understand revenue and usage patterns, identify deviations in usage, growth of new accounts, and determine trends in new subscriptions and their activations. And finally, at any time I can conveniently create online purchase orders for new subscriptions to quickly scale up the footprint of our connected assets in a timely manner towards the market and business demand.
Now let's look into how we can support you to monitor, diagnose, and control subscriptions for long-term quality robustness. As your deployment grows, a single pane view into your entire IoT deployment will be crucial, independently if you have an external or internal service.
Hi! My name is John, and I am part of the customer service organization. Our organization's key objective is to deliver the best customer service for mission-critical to best-effort IoT solutions. Independently of the service levels, this is how we use the connectivity management platform to ensure an ubiquitous service assurance is always delivered to our entire subscription base. WingHub provides me with all the capabilities and tools, which empower me to reach the ultimate goals for reduced overall costs of customer service. Such capabilities include a single pane of glass for diagnosis and troubleshooting supported by a wide set of SIM search filter options, range of SIMs, per ICC ID, MZM, SISDN, MI, tag, organization, tariff, and billing status, the subscriber view or SIM details drilling into event data records, EDR, call detail records, CDR. Insights into both current and historical data, the diagnostics report. The SMS delivery report, a proactive approach to issues through automation rules by setting watchdogs for proactive alerts, and the trigger of actions for network status changes, a NOR REST API requests. As part of service assurance is fundamental that I am able to take timely actions on problems, which impact performance and costs. Having a single pane of glass that allows me to diagnose and troubleshoot issues quickly and on first call is one of my KPIs. The wide range of search and filter options, such as billing status, organization, price plan or tags, I can quickly locate the SIMs with issues in a table. Each SIM comes with all the subscription-related information that empower me to pinpoint problems and get a better handle on the reliability and quality of their connectivity services. The SIM details are particularly useful for troubleshooting subscription connectivity and help me answer quickly questions such as, has the device been in a data session? What is the network status and the IP I'm assigned? I can also find here the PIN and the PUC. Additional information also helps with troubleshooting such as, the mobile station international subscriber directory number MSISDN which identifies a subscription uniquely in a GSM or UMTS mobile network. Whether the subscription is active in the mobile network through network status country in which the last recorded data or SMS session took place the IP address assigned to the subscription in the operator's network. Session status that shows whether a subscription is in an active data or SMS session at the time of file creation and also when the last session started and when it was closed, if not active. The VPN, which the device uses for internet access. Device IMEI identifying and validating mobile phones and other 3GPP cellular radio devices within a GSM or UMTS network, and can therefore be used to prevent fraudulent or stolen devices from accessing the respective mobile network personal identification number, PIN, for ordinary use, and personal unblocking key, PUC, for PIN unlocking. Subscription hardware is the type of card type as defined by the subscription provider, network provider. A subscription product can be used to define the account products. The platform counts the usage of each provisioned service type with a precise overview by having a hierarchy of counters. The highest level is the total consumption of a service type for a subscription, for example data, SMS. It is then followed by zones, countries and the mobile network in use. The usage counter parameters are counter level, which indicates the type of entity is an IMSI or an ICCID. Scope type, which indicates whether the real-time rating scope is a total zone, country, mobile network, network group or a session. The scope refers to either the overall usage, session usage, usage in a zone, country or network. Service indicates the online rating counter of the service type like data, SMS, sessions, etc. Current value indicates the number of usages counted. Depending on the service type, the counter value can represent a number of data octets, SMS messages or sessions counts. Periodicity indicates for which period it was counted like billing cycle, daily, or monthly. An event data record, EDR, is the most granular information that the connectivity management platform makes available for troubleshooting. Depending on the price plan, information about the use of the services is stored at short intervals. Since a stable session can take hours, I can use the EDR for more detailed analysis within a session. The historical overview of usage over a period, week or month helps me understand better the usage patterns of a SIM, identify deviations in usage, or detect systemic trends. Depending on our business and operational needs, the platform allows us to capture and maintain additional diagnostic information per SIM, namely, custom attributes and tags. Tags and custom attributes allow me to track subscriptions based on individual criteria. With custom attributes, any additional data can be stored in a structured manner. For example, SIM form factor, software status, application, maintenance, or sales team. Tagging of mobile subscribers and devices, things, is useful to describe the entity, for example, in terms of, its use case, ownership, project, form factor, software status, application, maintenance status, or cost center. Triggered rules give me further diagnostic capabilities with insights into the type of rules triggered whether in last 24 hours or billing cycle. Whether the rules are still active and which services are currently blocked by them, if that is the case. I can remove any currently blocked services to allow the SIM to return to consuming data services before the rule period is over. The WingHub Enterprise portal allows me to manage specific devices, which are non-standard computing devices that connect wirelessly to the network and have the ability to transmit data. I can assign one or multiple SIM cards to each device. This makes it possible to handle connectivity from a device-centric perspective, in addition to a SIM card-centric perspective. Devices, even if defined as single unit, they are also assigned to a device type which I can define on the platform. I can add device types from a range of types or create and assign a new one. If a SIM is used in a device, then I can check its device properties, making it possible to manage devices and their relationship with SIM cards and where they are installed. Similarly to accessing stored device properties, WingHub allows me to access the location where the device has been installed or by whom it is being used. I can also select and download diagnostics data such as location update event or authentication requests of a SIM during a given period of time. The Nokia WingHub interacts with the SMS center, so that I can refer to the SMS delivery report in order to check the status of SMSs sent to and from a SIM. I can extend my search from a starting to an ending date to collect SMS delivery data for the selected SIM. I can also select one message type from the list. The SMS delivery report results can be downloaded by exporting the SMS delivery report of the selected SIM.
Now let's look into how we can support you to protect your business assets from security vulnerabilities. Hi, my name is Ian, and I am responsible to ensure that malicious use is prevented. I also reduce the risk of subscription fraud and proactively act on changes of hardware or abnormal behaviors. When it comes to managing our Internet of Things, security is indispensable. That is why the single global real-time connectivity management platform enables interesting security capabilities to properly protect subscribers from serious vulnerabilities. WingHub offers me a three-pronged approach to device security and fraud prevention through the use of security profiles. 1. Detect devices using an unapproved IME. 2. Protect against unauthorized use by denying data and SMS service, disabling the device. And 3. Get notified immediately via email or SMS. Roaming profiles also empower me to geofence SIMs and get notified when a SIM goes outside a specific, predefined geography. I also get a more proactive approach to ensuring protection from security vulnerability through automation rules, which automatically deactivate devices upon policy violations. I can ensure that data is only allowed when the whitelist includes the device's IME, or the SMS can only be sent or received from those MSIS DNS included in the whitelist. Therefore, any IME or MSIS DNS not listed in the whitelist will be denied access to data or SMS service. Similarly, I can deny data when I ensure the device's IME ID is included in the blacklist, or SMS cannot be sent or received from MSIS DNS that I have included in the blacklist. As such, when creating a security profile, I need to specify its applicability and namely, whether it is a specific subscriber or IMSI, an entire account, or a specific hierarchical level. I also need to specify which services need the security restrictions, that is, whether a data IME lock or SMS service. WingHub allows me to manage the SMS and data security profiles assigned to a SIM. I can add or remove security profiles for one or multiple SIMs. I can view the details of the security profile and assign it to the whitelist or blacklist for any given SIM.
So why is IoT connectivity management with dynamic, in the moment, innovation capabilities so relevant and important? As an enterprise, you need to be empowered to perform key tasks on your own self-service portal anytime, anywhere. Optimize connectivity costs with the power of real-time control of the entire subscription lifecycle that keeps you always aligned with your cost objectives for the commercial handling of your IoT M2M business. Minimize service support costs only achieved with unique real-time and proactive care capabilities. Prevent IoT fraud and its unavoidably incurred expenses wherever your business needs take you and provide hassle-free, secure deployment and operation of your global fleet of devices.